Legal o illegal man ang kanyang pagpasok sa iyong DM, stalking stage man yan o matagal-tagal na rin mula nung kayo ay huling nag-usap. Here is some dating advice for you in your years in law school. All of this and more coming right up!
This episode is brought to you by Dekada! 10 life lessons from 10 years in law school. Sa akdang ito, ako na ang nagkamali, nadapa, lumuha at nasaktan para ikaw kapatid ay makatapos sa loob ng 4 o 6 na taon. Think of it as a game guide, a cheat sheet that you can use throughout your law school journey. By purchasing this ebook, you are sowing the seeds of free legal aid for those who fall within the gaps of the law. With your help, we can bring the law to the people and more people to the law. Grab your copy through the link in the description down below.
Hi, my name is Lex and welcome to Lex in Motion. In this channel, I'll be helping you build your competence, confidence, and capability in law school. Start today by hitting the subscribe button below. New episodes are posted every Friday. Law school dating advice number 1. Lumandi lamang ng naaayon sa class standing. Laging tatandaan kapatid na ikaw ay pumasok sa law school para maging abogado o abogada. At hindi para lang makapangasawa ng abogado. Hindi kanila lang ng Diyos sa lupa para lamang manatiling under bar habang buhay. At maging driver lang ng isang abogada o maging life partner ng current law school jowa mo. All of that begins by tempering your baser instincts. Lumandi ka lamang nang naaayon sa iyong class standing. Kung ang huling 4 mong resit ay feeling mo lang, na itawid mo, maniwala ka kapatid. Feeling mo lang iyon. Feeling mo lang na itawid mo pero 65 ang sinulat ng professor mo sa kanyang class records. Kung ikaw naman ay namamayagpag sa iyong law school journey, ay bakit mo pasisi sirain ang mabuti mong nasimulan. Ang iyong pananatili sa Dean's List ay hindi lamang magbubunga ng magandang reputation. Instant ganda points ay mawawalan ka rin siguro ng oras na humarot dahil biglang damay ka na sa maraming extracurricular activities ng bar ops, ng school o ng iyong sorority. Again, hindi bawal ang magkajowa sa law school kapatid. Sometimes the best relationships you'll ever have are those born in the crucible where you are forged into something of worth in the crucible of law school. Law school dating advice number 2, beware of bar lust. In our previous episodes, I mentioned about the dangers of dating baristas. Huwag na huwag kang lalandi ng barista dahil masasaktan ka, magkakasakitan kayo, o sakit ang aabutin mo. Here's why. Mahirap ipaliwanag kapatid pero lahat ng barista ay nasisiraan ng bait. Hindi mo ito maiintindihan until and unless you have to take the bar exam. But I want to give you the heads up just in case. Lahat ng barista ay nasisiraan ng bait dahil sa pressure ng bar exam. Imagine kapatid na lahat ng binasa, niluha at iniyak mo ng 4 hanggang 6 na taon ay masusubukan lamang sa loob ng 2 o 4 na araw. Kahit na wala kang binagsak nung nasa law school ka ay matinding pressure pa rin ang iyong mararamdaman. Kung ikaw naman ay sumabit-sabit lang bit-bit ng iyong study group, mas malaki ang pressure dahil alam mo wala kang kasama sa mismong exam. Walang GC na pwedeng buksan at kuhanan ng sagot. The immense pressure coupled with the enormity of the occasion is enough to make even the best of us crack, cave, and collapse under all of that weight. The bar exam is pretty much a mental game and when your mental health suffers, you have to deal with it in any way, shape, or form. During my bar exam, I was tempted to go back to old habits. Readers of Dekada will know I struggled with substance abuse. But with the grace of God, my sobriety remains intact today. However, I did struggle with eating and overeating during my review. Labas ang lahat ng mga fatboy pants na may garter sa gilid-gilid. Labas lahat ng mga polo na Andrew E. ang luwag. However, I hit a wall in the last 30 days before the bar exam. Food became tasteless for me and I found myself eating less and less. My mentor at that time says this is normal. But it usually begins during the pre-week and lasts until the weeks after the bar exam. Sa karamihan ng mga barista, lumalabas ang kanilang toyo at topak sa isang phenomenon na kung tawagin ay bar lust. Hindi ito masyadong napag-uusapan but it happens to the best of us. Being in a particularly vulnerable position, there might be a point in your bar review where bar lust hits and you become emotionally, mentally, and physically attracted to your bar body, to your bar operator, or generally kahit sinong maling tao. This is because these people provide some form of mental and emotional support during the darkest chapter of your life. Be careful who you spend this time with because you may fall in love for all the wrong reasons. What you might actually call love is actually a series of biochemical reactions happening in a chemically imbalanced brain. That is why my advice, kapatid, ay huwag na huwag kang lalandi ng barista. If you are in a talking stage with a barrister, keep your distance until after his or her exams. If after the exam, if after the lapse of a reasonable amount of time, if you still feel the same way, then you may pursue the relationship. On the one hand, ang mga barista ay madaling mapaibig, malinlang, madarang at maloko ng mga taong sadyang madulas ang dila ay bastos. Sila din ang madalas maging biktima ng mga maling mga tao at sadyang sinasakyan lang na emotionally vulnerable at needy rin sila. On the other hand, you also have distracted baristas, or more precisely, baristas who wish to distract themselves. Meron at meron ng bawat batch, review center, barkada o dating mga magkakaklase na nagiging manipulative, manluloko at mapangahas. These people are out for themselves. They need the physical release demanded by their raging hormones. And that is that. If it is between two consenting adults, then it shouldn't be an issue. If you cannot be careful, at least please be safe. Law school dating advice number 3. Group aral is fake aral. Malayong matalino ang pwede mong maging output sa law school kung ikaw ay magbabasa lamang all on your own. Hindi ka pwedeng umangkas sa talino ng iba dahil hiwalay o iba na ang pagkakaunawa nila sa batas sa loob ng isang group study session. I've always said it on the channel and the advice still holds true today. Often the best way to learn something is by teaching it to someone else. The members of your study group are always in different phases of the learning process. Maaring ikaw ay nilalamon na ng trabaho at wala ka pa ring matinong basa. Sasama ka ngayon sa isang group study session at ang purpose mo ay makikinig lamang. Ang mahirap dito, kapatid, ay ang quality ng aral mo. The law demands precision in everything we do. What you may be learning from your classmates will always be incomplete, imprecise, and inaccurate in relation to the precise language of the law, in relation to the full text decisions of the Supreme Court, and in relation to the learned discussion of your textbook authors. I hope I am making sense so far. Every study group will always have the one or two alphas who have already put in the time, the energy, and the attention to learn the law. These people often have prepared ahead of time. Their purpose in participating in a group study session is not to learn from you. Wala ka naman kasing ambag kasi hindi ka rin naman nagbasa. Sumasama sila sa study group o nagsisimula sila ng study group para magkaroon sila ng live studio audience na maaaring makinig sa kanilang mga natutunan. Naroon sila para mag-practice ng recitation sa inyo na mga mangmang. Kung merong mas matalino sa kanila, nauuwi ito minsan sa intense na debate o nananahimik na lang ang may alam ng mas tamang sagot. Group aral is fake aral because not everyone in your group is going to be ready to contribute to the level of learning that the law requires. What you may be feeding your brain are the words of justice classmate lang at hindi kung ano mismo ang kailangan mong matutunan sa batas. Law school dating advice number 4. It is statistically improbable that you will meet the love of your life in law school. Most of your classmates might be outside of your preferred age range. Some of your classmates may be throwing off plenty of red flags. Often, we are in classes where there are cute people who know nothing like Jon Snow. There are those who come loaded with guns blazing, but whose faces and bodies could only be loved by their own mothers. This is the harsh reality of law school, kapatid. So when you find the love of your life in law school, hang on to this person. Never let this person go. Do not live a life of regrets, what ifs, and doubts that might creep in long after you have forgotten all about this person. Speaking of the love of your life, kapatid, kung kailangan mo pang itanong kung si XX o si YY ba ang yung love of your life, then it is very, very possible that that person is not the love of your life. The love of your life is the person you choose to spend forever with. For all the cases on nullity of marriage that you've read, digested, and passed to your professors, for all the cases on vowsy and abuse that you have read, then you must also come to the same conclusion that the love of your life is a choice. Here's what I mean. Love is a decision. It should never be confused with a series of biochemical reactions in your brain, which triggers an increased heart rate, rapid breathing, and the dilation of your pupils. That, kapatid, is attraction on a primal or purely physiological level. Love is a choice. It is the choice not only to remain with one person, but to grow with that person. Although the family code requires no form for the solemnity of marriage, it does require the consent of two adults. This consent not only happens on the day you get married, but a constant choice you make day in and day out. It is the decision to love the same person in this lifetime and in the next. Law school dating advice number 5. Take care of your heart. Law school is a terrible, terrible place to be, kapatid. Lahat naman tayo ay nahihirapan, nasasaktan, at madalas ay pakiramdam natin na parang hindi na nga tayo umaandar. Ay minsan napapaatras pa. You are not alone in this struggle, kapatid. The photos you see on your online classes are also going through the same struggle. The pain you feel is real, but it is not for you to bear alone. The joy you will feel hollow if you don't share it with the people that matter. First and foremost, on the list of the people who matter, should be yourself. Ikaw at ikaw mismo, kapatid, ang balang araw ay papasok sa isang gusali sa Padre Faura. Do not lose yourself in your struggle. Always, always take care of your heart because God has given you a good heart. Happy Valentine's Day 2023, kapatid. Maraming salamat sa ilang minuto na tayo ay naupo at nag-usap dito. If you would like to see more episodes on how to build your confidence in law school, please let me know by typing yes in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. Like and share this video for good law school karma, and I will see you next Friday.